नमस्कार. गेल्या 9 महिन्यांपूर्वी जेव्हा मी विचार करत होतो की भारत इस्रायल आपल्या संयुक्त विद्यमाने एक शिक्षकांसाठी प्रशिक्षण शिबिर आयोजित करायचं, तेव्हाही पहिले कल्पना प्रत्यक्षात येईल असं वाटत नव्हतं. त्यानंतर अनेक महिन्यांचा त्याच्यात वेळ गेला आणि काल जेव्हा कार्यक्रम सुरू झाला तेव्हा वाटलं नव्हतं की इतक्या लवकर हा कार्यक्रम इतक्या चांगल्या पद्धतीने आणि इतक्या लवकर संपेल. पण शेवटी प्रत्येक कार्यक्रम हा कधी ना कधीतरी संपत असतोच. आणि आज आपल्याकडे इस्रायली एक्सपर्ट्स आहेत, त्यांच्यापैकी काही जण आज रात्रीच्याच विमानांनी परत जात आहेत, त्यामुळे आपली इच्छा असूनही आपल्याला हा कार्यक्रम थोडासा आटोपता घ्यावा लागत आहे. म्हणून आता हा समारोपाचा कार्यक्रम आपण सुरू करत आहोत. कार्यक्रमाच्या सुरुवातीला मी आपल्या सगळ्यांचे आभार मानू इच्छितो की आपण सगळ्या एवढ्या दुरून आलात आणि सगळ्यांनी एक म्हणजे खरोखर कोलॅबोरेटिव्ह लर्निंग किंवा एक टीम स्पिरिट दाखवत खूप चांगला वेळ गेला. तर या कार्यक्रमाबद्दल थोडंसं आपले मतं व्यक्त करण्यासाठी मी इस्रायलचे डेप्युटी कॉन्सुल जनरल मतान जमीर यांना बोलत आहे. मतान, प्लीज कम अँड इफ यू कुड ॲड्रेस द टीचर्स व्हॉट वॉज युअर एक्सपिरियन्स अँड हाऊ डीड यू फाईंड दिस ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम. अँड
Hello, good evening again. Good to see you again. I will be brief. We had a conversation yesterday, so I don't want to take a lot of your time. You have to go home and some of you have a long way. I would just like to say thank you. First of all, I would like to say thank you for you, for participating, for being curious, for asking questions, for opening your minds to new ideas and new methods and maybe things that you know but you don't think about on the everyday basis, because as the minister said and as my consul general said yesterday, most of the things are already being done. Some things are happening in one school, the second thing is happening in a different school, maybe one teacher is doing, but this is a good opportunity to just take you out of your everyday box and everyday life and just interest you in other methods and other ideas that are happening in other places. And I remember this, Dov, I remember your sentence from today: think globally but do locally. And this is basically the message of these 2 days. So nothing is copy paste in education, nothing is just, yeah, they're doing it this in Israel, they're doing it this in other places, let's do the same, because culture is different, people are different, feelings are different. But the idea is just to see what can be done, what can be adopted, what can be taken, what can be changed, or how can we think differently. So I would like to thank you for these 2 days. My impression for these 2 days is incredible. I think that my minds were open just from participating in some of the lectures, and I've seen you and I've seen your curiosity and I've seen your questions and I've seen your interest, and I would like to thank you for that, because it's very easy just to sit and listen, but then to participate and to experience, this is basically learning by doing, to experience yourself, is it takes energy, but you've done it, I believe all of you've done it, and I believe this has been beneficial for our experts and you. So that was the mutual cooperation. I would like to thank our partners in the government, in Maharashtra government, and I would like to thank ORF. Mr. Kulkarni, you were not here yesterday during the opening. You're traveling to important places, but I have to tell you, these 2 days for us were a great success. And I would like to thank our friends from Israel, our experts, that took the time coming from their everyday work and took this week and visited schools and attended these 2 days and gave from their knowledge and gave from their experience and took a lot from all of you. So I would just like to conclude by saying that, as the minister said yesterday, this is step one, and this event cannot be isolated. It cannot be just a single event and then we'll all go back to our schools. This is a beginning of a process, and I'm happy to say that we already had discussions with government and with our partners to make this event into something sustainable and to something that will last for a long time. So thank you again very, very much.
Thank you very much, Matan. Now I request Dr. Shahaf Gal, to share his impressions of the workshop and maybe give some guidance about what's the course ahead. Dr. Shah.
Hello everyone. By now we know each other a little bit better, and I'm very grateful and happy for that. I think we are moving along. It's a long road, it's okay. You know, when we first came, all of us, the experts, we talked a lot, and also it was mentioned by your minister and others, about the issue of big numbers. You know, 20 million children, students, and 600,000, 700,000 teachers, and so on. I want to say that I come here, come out of these 2 days with a feeling that the big numbers shouldn't be a concern to us. We shouldn't be afraid. Every beginning is a small beginning, and it begins with a single person, one person. This is also what innovation is about. It's about people, about a person doing something different. So let's not be all concerned about the big numbers. If each one of us does something, and if we have taken something from here, I've taken a lot. I hope you have taken something from these 2 days. I believe you have. Then we're in the right direction. Let's just continue and go along. So I'm very happy to be here, and thank you very much.
Now I request Mr. Dov Kuiperman to come and share his views.
I'm going to start the new session.
Yeah.
First of all, I want to thank ORF, Oparna and her team. They were amazing. They helped us so much, even mentality. We are so excited. We didn't know what to do. They were calm us. Everything will be okay. It was very well organized. So thank you. Oparna, you have to listen to it. I'm talking about you. Okay? So thank you personally for your work. For me, it's the first time I came to India. I've been here for 4 days. I'm sure I'm going home. I'm going to absorb what I've seen here. There are some things that I learned here. I feel that there are some things that I teach you here. I hope I will come next year. I will see if you are implementing it. But let me give you some short guidelines as teachers. Because you know, all of you have been in my session, and basically, I am not a general manager, I am a teacher, and I'm talking to you as a teacher. If you regard skills, everybody is talking about fostering skills. If you regard skills not as a talent, as a skill that you can foster it, this will be the first thing to start working on it with students. And about the innovation, Shahaf was talking about innovation. And let me tell you something from my 40 years experience. If you want to do it, innovation is, part of it comes from top down and part of it from bottom up. But there is three essential conditions to do any change in education. The first condition is that you as teacher must feel dissatisfaction from the current situation. But this is not enough. The second condition is that somebody will help you and show you another option. That's what we have done in the last 2 days. We have shown you a new other options, and we have shown you how we can implement it. And the second condition, it can work if you will have an ongoing support, pedagogical support, organizational support. I'm not saying that this is enough, I know, believe me, I was speaking with Ane about, I told him about my white hair and from the Israeli Ministry of Education. I'm not going to it, but I understand part of the problems. We have the same problems. What is a challenge is to like Shachav said, let's deal with it. Even in a big scale, it's a challenge. Today I've experienced a session with 70 teachers. I never done it in Israel, and I feel from the response that I have to from you that it was successful. So now you gave me confidence. Thank you.
Now I request Mr. Ojas Wildman to come and share his views about the workshop.
Hello everybody. First of all, also I want to join the thanks for the ORF and the Ministry of Education of Maharashtra and the Israeli Embassy that organize and make this come true. So thanks a lot. Beside that, I learned a lot, and I want to thank you that you give me the place to give. So when you have the opportunity to give to somebody, you get fulfilled. So thanks you for giving me this opportunity. I believe we are, as education people, especially the teachers, basically we got the privilege to be a servant of the society, in service of the kids, okay? And this may be the highest place that a human being can reach, and it's a lot, and so you must feel privileged every day when you go to work. One more thing, you are the pioneer of this innovation in education, and I believe as the pioneer, Maharashtra will be the pioneer of India, and slowly we spread it all over. So as Dov said before, every long distant journey starts with one step. So this is our first steps, and I hope I can be your partner for the next steps. Thank you very much.
आता मी श्री हेमंत लागवणकरांना विनंती करतो की त्यांनी आपल्यामध्ये येऊन कार्य मराठीत बोललं तरी म्हणजे सगळ्यांना कुठली भाषा जास्त सुटेबल आहे ते मराठीत येते.
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आय थँक ORF. Sudhindra Kulkarni sir is here, he is chairman of ORF. Thank you sir. I thank Aparna madam, Ane sir, because through them I am here in front of you. Though many of you know me personally because we worked together in past. Many of you might have read my articles, but I think nobody is here who heard me before. And I thank ORF for that, because they gave us a chance to interact directly with some different roles. And I also thank our friends from Israel for being with us, interacting about their experiences, sharing their experiences, talking about their educational system, so that so many things we can get, and of course we can obviously take good from it, try to implement, try to fit, try to modify in our context, and we definitely can utilize this content, this experience, and of course, as I have said in my presentation, you are the game changers. Ojas said you are the pioneers. I have used the word game changers. So you can change the game and you can play wonders. So I hope this is the stepping stone, this is the beginning, and I'm sure Dov sir that will be consistent when you come again in Israel, from Israel. Definitely these participants, these teachers will share the experiences, what they have felt after this training. So thank you, and once for all, thank you for being with us and having a nice interaction. Thank you.
मी आता MSCERT चे संचालक श्री जरग साहेबांना विनंती करतो. त्यांनी मला सांगितलं की आमची प्रशिक्षण शिबिरं नेहमीच चालू असतात, पण तरी मला असं वाटतं या प्रसंगी आपल्या शिक्षकांना थोडे त्यांच्या पाठीवर कौतुकाची थाप देण्यासाठी त्यांनी पुढे यावं आणि आपले विचार मांडावेत. जरग साहेब प्लीज.
ओरएफ रिसर्च फाउंडेशन ऑब्झर्वर रिसर्च फाउंडेशनचे चेअरमन आणि त्यांचे सर्व सहकारी, इस्रायल मधून आलेले रिसोर्स पर्सन्स, इस्रायल कॉन्सुलेट आणि आपले महाराष्ट्रातले SCERT डायट्स, टीचर एज्युकेटर्स आणि शिक्षक बंधू भगिनी, 10-15 दिवसापूर्वी एक वेगळी उत्सुकता मनामध्ये होती की ऑब्झर्वर रिसर्च फाउंडेशन ही संस्था एक वर्कशॉप आयोजित करणार आहे आणि महाराष्ट्र शासन त्याच्यामध्ये इन्व्हॉल्व आहे आणि एक छोटी मीटिंग मुंबईला झालेली होती आणि त्यानंतर पुणे ही ठिकाण त्या ठिकाणी ठरलं आणि SCERT वर सेकंड ऑर्गनायझरची जबाबदारी आली, कारण फर्स्ट ऑर्गनायझर हे महाराष्ट्र शासन आहे आणि ORF आहे. आणि ज्यावेळेला आमच्यावर जबाबदारी आली त्यावेळेला हे कशा पद्धतीनं असावं याचं बरंचसं विचारमंथन झालं आणि आमच्या पुढे प्रश्न पडला की इनोव्हेशन्सवर वर्कशॉप करायचे आहेत म्हणजे काय करायचं. मी एकच त्यातनं थिंकिंग विचारात घेतलं की जे काम करतात, जी मंडळी काम करतात त्यांनाच काहीतरी वेगळे विचार सुचतात, जे कामच करत नाहीत त्यांना विचार सुचणं कठीण आहे. त्यामुळं काम करणारी माणसं कोण आहेत ती पहिले शोधायचं काम करू. आणि जे जी मंडळी आम्हाला गेल्या 10 वर्षामध्ये काम करताना भेटली, ज्याच्यामध्ये आम्हाला काहीतरी वेगळं वाटलं, अशी सगळी मंडळी एकत्र आणण्याचा प्रयत्न या ठिकाणी केलेला. आणि ही सगळी मंडळी 2 दिवस ज्यावेळेला आम्ही क्लासरूममध्ये इंटरॅक्शन रिसोर्स पर्सनच्या बरोबर जे इंटरॅक्शन सुरू होतं त्यामध्ये ज्यावेळेला पाहिलं त्यावेळेला निश्चितच आपण जी निवडलेली मंडळी आहे ती त्यांनी निवड सार्थ केलेली आहे आणि चांगल्या प्रकारे पार्टिसिपेट करतायत हे त्या ठिकाणी मला आढळून आलं. प्रत्येक प्रशिक्षण कशासाठी आहे, प्रशिक्षण उदंड झाली अशा प्रकारे सुद्धा शब्दप्रयोग केला जातो, परंतु शब्दप्रयोग करणं सोपं असतं, प्रशिक्षणातून घ्यायला काय मिळतं. पहिलं महत्त्वाचं असतं ते विचारांची देवाणघेवाण. आणि मागच्या कालच्या आणि आजच्या दिवसामध्ये आपण एकमेकांमध्ये किती इंटरॅक्शन केली, परस्परांशी किती बोललो. त्यांनी एक प्रश्न विचारला होता की एका तासामध्ये आपण मुलांना किती प्रश्न विचारतो, त्याच्यापेक्षा कितीतरी प्रश्न तुम्ही एकमेकाला विचारले गेले 2 दिवस. दिस इज द इंटरॅक्शन. हे इंटरॅक्शन महत्त्वाचं आहे आणि पुन्हा हे इंटरॅक्शन विथ रिसोर्सेस, हे दोन्ही गोष्टी ह्या अत्यंत आपल्याला चांगल्या प्रकारे झालेल्या आहेत. आणि ज्या वेळेला अशा प्रकारचं इंटरॅक्शन होतं त्यावेळेला पुन्हा ज्यावेळेला आपण आपल्या फील्डवरती आपल्या कामामध्ये परत जातो त्यावेळेला आपण जे काम काल करत होतो ते आज करताना पुन्हा वेगळा विचार करतो. काम तेच असतं पण विचाराची दिशा ही बदललेली असते आणि ते ह्या प्रशिक्षणातून साध्य झालेलं असं मला वाटतं. थँक्यू इस्रायली कॉन्सुलेट, ORF च्या सर्व सदस्यांना धन्यवाद आणि आमच्या सगळ्या मंडळींनी सुद्धा चांगलं पार्टिसिप केलं आणि सहयोग चांगला दिला त्याबद्दल धन्यवाद. थँक्यू.
धन्यवाद जरग साहेब. आता मी ऑब्झर्वर रिसर्च फाउंडेशनचे अध्यक्ष श्री सुधींद्र कुलकर्णीजींना विनंती करतो की त्यांनी आपल्यासमोर आपल्याला मार्गदर्शन करावे आणि याच्या पुढची काय दिशा राहू शकते त्याच्याबद्दलही थोडस सांगावं.
Thank you. Shri Jarak, Mr. Mathan, Dr. Shah Gal, Mr. Dov Kupperman, Mr. Ojas Waldman, Hemant Lagwankarji. मी काल इथे उपस्थित राहू शकलो नाही कारण मी पाकिस्तानच्या दौऱ्यावर गेलो होतो. मी सर्वप्रथम महाराष्ट्र शासनाचा मनःपूर्वक आभार मानू इच्छितो. आय एम पर्टिक्युलरली ग्रेटफुल फ्रेंड्स टू द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर अँड द ऑनरेबल सेक्रेटरी श्रीमती अश्विनी भिडे हॅज बीन द ड्रायव्हिंग फोर्स behind this workshop. So I want to thank Ashwini Bhide and her colleagues on behalf of the Observer Research Foundation. I also want to thank His Excellency Mr. Jonathan Miller, who is now going to leave us shortly, but it was his determination that before he left his office as the Consul General of Israel in Mumbai, he would like to see this idea of workshop come true. And it has indeed happened. We are grateful to you, Mr. Mathan, and please convey our thanks to the Consul General. Our very special thanks to the distinguished experts, trainers who have come all the way from Israel. I attended only a few sessions, but I must say that it was truly a learning experience for me, just as it was a learning experience for each one of you. I want to thank all the participating teachers and other educators. I was witness to your enthusiasm, your active participation, which really has made this workshop a huge success. Friends, I want all of us to give a big hand to the team from the ORF that has worked. Aparna, Anay, Dhaval, Janki, Aditi, Rachel, Sumedh, Dhruv, Sunil, Jayesh, and several others. Their hard work, their commitment is what has made this workshop a big success. Friends, why did we organize this workshop? And why this workshop in collaboration with Israel? Even though it may have been mentioned to you in the inaugural session, let me briefly retrace the origin of this workshop. It all began with this report by my colleague Aparna Shivkumar, which itself was the outcome of her visit to Israel to participate in a Mashal program on innovation in education. She produced this wonderful report, which was released at a function by the Honorable Chief Secretary of Maharashtra, Shri Saharia Ji. He appreciated the recommendations that have been made in this report, and I hope that each one of you has picked up a copy of this, both in English and Marathi. So we felt that there is a big opportunity for us and also a big task upon us to strengthen this collaboration between Israel and Maharashtra. There is so much that we need to learn from this tiny but a miracle nation called Israel. I call it a miracle nation because India is 158 times bigger and our population is 162 times bigger than that of Israel. Just to give you an idea, and I'm sure that by now each one of you knows this, Israel's population is less than that of Mumbai. And yet, we know what unbelievable accomplishments this small nation, surrounded by countries that are hostile to it, a country that has very, very little natural resources. If Israel has achieved all this, principally it is because of its education system, and therefore we have a lot to learn from Israel. And it is out of this realization that, friends, we felt in our conversation with the Consul General that we need to now have a lot of follow-up programs. Of course, it's not possible to have more and more teachers visit Israel to participate in Mashav or Mashav-like programs. So we felt that why not bring experts from Israel and bring teachers like you, and out of this interaction, enrich the knowledge, experience of educators and teachers in India, in Maharashtra in particular, so that over a period of time, we spread the culture of innovation in the school education system in Maharashtra. This is not the end of our collaboration. I'm sure that this is a stepping stone for many more activities to come, activities that will once again see this trilateral collaboration between the government of Maharashtra, the Consulate of Israel, and ORF. Friends, I want to mention that we have a colossal challenge and a colossal opportunity in education, especially school education. It's not that Israeli people are endowed with some superior intelligence. It's not that they're brainier than people elsewhere in the world, including India. Because God has given the same intelligence to every human being on earth. But the difference is the system of education that brings up the latent intelligence amongst human beings and make them productive citizens, citizens who help themselves, their families, their communities, and their nation, and the humanity as a whole. As Swami Vivekananda said, education is that system which brings to perfection what is already latent in human beings. So, this is our understanding of education. We have a very rich and long tradition of education in our own country. Unfortunately, in recent centuries and even after independence, we have not been able to develop a system of education, a system of school education that enriches, that develops the latent intelligence amongst our children. The problem in school education is known to all of us. Each year, Pratham brings out its ASAR report, which tells us how our system is failing our children. मी दुपारी जेवणाच्या वेळी तुमच्या एका शिक्षण अधिकारीशी बोलत होतो. ते म्हणाले की महाराष्ट्रात कित्येक असे गावं आहेत चौथी पाचवी शिकणाऱ्या मुलांना नाव लिहिता येत नाही, गणिताचं प्राथमिक ज्ञान नाही. What will these children do when they grow up? What a colossal waste of human resource. And therefore, friends, I believe that the time has come. You know, we all should welcome the fact that the government of India has brought in this right to education through a legislation. Right to education is good, but it's not enough. We need right to quality education, not just RTE, but RTQE, right to quality education. And it's because of the lack of quality education that tens of thousands of students are leaving government schools, municipal schools, and going to private schools. Now this is a big, big challenge before the government system. Now if this continues, you know, government will not be able to say that it is performing its basic duty of educating every Indian citizen. And there will be a new class system of Indians who have quality education and Indians who are deprived of quality education. All this must end. And therefore, friends, this workshop, which is focused on innovation in education, which is focused on improving quality of education in our school system, it has a very big national significance. So I want to appeal to each one of you. You have been the beneficiary of this very rare opportunity of interacting with great experts from Israel. I'm sure that each one of you has benefited from this workshop. When you go back, each one of you should become a change agent. I hope that it was mentioned yesterday that the Observer Research Foundation has taken an initiative to create a larger platform called Change Agents for School Education and Research. Unless we make quality and innovation in education a mass movement, we will not be able to change the situation. You know, I was particularly struck by what you said, sir, that there should be a deep sense of dissatisfaction at the situation prevailing. If we are not dissatisfied, if we are not angry, there won't be change. What should we be angry about? Who are the enemies of quality? Who are the enemies of innovation in our system? Let me mention two. One, political interference. Political interference in the way school system runs is the principal reason why the government-run schools are getting a bad name. This must end. The second big enemy of quality is corruption. You know, I was talking to some of you, and of course it's well known, especially in the state of Maharashtra, there is corruption in everything. Corruption in the midday meal scheme, corruption in the purchase of uniforms. How can we assure quality if this continues? So there is a big responsibility on you, and there is a big responsibility on us to raise our voice against corruption. Corruption and quality cannot go together. So the Observer Research Foundation will continue to work closely with the government of Maharashtra in improving, enriching school education. We are extremely happy with the kind of cooperation that we've got from the government. There are very good officers, committed officers in the government. If we all work together, we can certainly change the system. And let us, friends, dream of a day when we hold similar workshops in other parts of the world, and the theme should be what Israel can learn from Maharashtra, what Brazil can learn from Maharashtra, what other countries can learn from Maharashtra, and some of you people should have the opportunity to go and conduct similar workshops. So with these words, I want to express my deep appreciation at the success of this workshop. I want to thank each one of you, and I want to affirm that the Observer Research Foundation and the Change Agents for School Education and Research will continue to work with you, work with the educators in Maharashtra, with a very specific aim. Within a very short period, we must achieve results, friends. Thank you very much.
मी सुधींद्र धन्यवाद सुधींद्रजी खूप प्रेरणादायी भाषण हे होतं. आपल्याबरोबर आता या दोन दिवसाच्या वर्कशॉपमध्ये एम एस सी आर टीचे काही आपले अधिकारी आहेत की ज्यांनी याच्यात खूप तळमळीने काम केलं आणि हे वर्कशॉप यशस्वी करण्यात खूप मोठं योगदान दिलं, त्यांना आपण सर्टिफिकेट देणार आहोत सुधींद्रजींच्या हस्ते. मी नावं घेणार आहे, त्यांनी समोर येऊन सर्टिफिकेट घ्यायचंय. श्री अशोक भोसले सर, श्री महेश चौथे, रमाकांत काटमोरे, श्रीमती प्रिया शिंदे सुरेश माळी, पद्मजा लांबरूड, शैला दराडे, प्रिया शिंदे नाही आहेत ना. नाव विल रिक्वेस्ट माय कलीग फ्रॉम ऑब्झर्व रिसर्च फाउंडेशन मिस अपर्णा शिवकुमार टू गिव्ह वोट ऑफ प्रिया शिंदे. I request Aparna to give vote of thanks to participants and announce closure of this program. Aparna.
Another one. So hi everyone, and I hope you had a very good time these last 2 days as much as we had. Thanks to all of you for having taken 2 days of your time and spending it with us. And if there have been any problems, any issues, we apologize and we hope to correct them. And for that matter, the feedback, your feedback is extremely important. And you can drop your feedback forms when you leave. And we will be, I also want to thank everyone who's been a part of this, apart from, of course, you. So first of all, the government of Maharashtra, starting from the RMSA team, the MSCRT team, whom we appreciated right now. They've been helping us so much and we troubled them a lot. And often enough, many things that we wanted done, they did it even without us realizing. And of course, the consulate, Matan, Anay, and all the Israeli experts, and of course, Hemant also, who had come. And I just quickly asked him, can you please do a session for us? And he agreed so quickly. And I really consider myself fortunate for that. And I also want to thank my ORF team. If you don't mind some dramatics, I'd like them to come and quickly take a bow. I know you've been seeing them through the sessions, but I just want them to come and say a hi over here. I think they'll come slowly, they're a little slow. And I want to request a few things over here. So one is the feedback form itself, which you can drop when you're collecting the certificates. Good. So we've written them. And so you can collect them. So there are two counters as you exit. So one for group one and another for group two. Also, here's my team. Please, Bo. So for the certificates, again, we have two counters, one for group one and another for group two. Okay, there may be a little problem in getting your name, but we'll try as far as possible. People whose attendance was not taken, you'll just have to put in your name over there and you'll get the certificates. Your feedback forms will also go with there. And one reflective thing which I wanted you all to do, if possible. So what did you learn from this session? What is it that you take away from this session which you can implement in your job, in your classrooms? And what is it that you want to learn more, so that this will be very important inputs that we can carry back with us to figure how we can work more with you. And so the email ID, my email ID, I think I've given some people, but I'll just repeat it right now, APARNA@orfonline.org. Otherwise, it's there behind the book that you have. And so this is one little exercise in addition to the feedback form, if possible, you should do. And you all asked for the resources, the presentations, and every other resource material. Unfortunately, since we didn't have time to consolidate in advance, we'll email it to you. We'll also upload it onto some link from where you can download it. And people who do not have access to it, we'll see how we can reach it across to you through a CD. So if you don't get it, holler, please send us an email, and we'll get it addressed. Yes, and okay, I have to do this one more piece. So which is, at ORF, we've launched a platform, which our chairman, Shri Sudhindra Kulkarni ji, talked about, which is, we're calling it as Change Agents for School Education and Research. And amongst each and every one of you are the great change agents. And see, at all points in time when we are talking about education between Israel and Maharashtra, we keep talking about this 8 million versus the Maharashtra size. But another way of looking at it is, if they are 8 million, we can do so many more times more. And with a little bit of input from us, I think them and many other experts and experts within, I think we can change the way the school education system and the way we progress overall. So I would like you to like our Facebook page. Our Facebook page is facebook.com/orf.caser. I'll probably write that also during when we leave, and we also emailed it to you. So please be a part of our Change Agent platform, and I really look forward to. Okay, so Israel also wants you to like them. So please also like Israel's Israel in Mumbai Facebook page, and be clued on their activities too. First case, sir. And we'll keep you posted. I look forward to working with each and every one of you as we go forward, and look forward to hearing your input. And thank you so much. And sorry I took more time than I should have. So bye. Thank you so much.